hundreds just attended Mike's first birthday party. Today is his birthday, and these are the stragglers from that celebration because people just can't get enough of him. It also marks his 1 month anniversary being here on the LSU campus. How he's stealing the hearts of thousands.
Happy birthday.
You get a first birthday party with 500 admirers, but LSU's new Tiger Mike VII certainly did. President and Chancellor Dr. King Alexander says hundreds drop in daily.
Every day we see just lines of cars and parks. I think the parking area actually is full of people just coming to see Mike. And, he was very excited a few minutes ago. He's sound asleep.
Just like a baby.
Just like a one-year-old. Just like a one-year-old. Exactly.
Sharing Mike's birthday is one of his biggest fans, one-year-old Claire Cooney.
Don't mess with my tutu. Don't mess with my tutu. Now you can have the other woman. But don't mess with
my... He texted me yesterday and said Mike's birthday party is tomorrow, and I knew exactly who he was talking about. And I said, we'll be going. So we've had a fun, exciting day, and we needed to come celebrate her birthday with Mike.
It's befitting Claire and Mike were born on the same day. Her parents, Monica and Ryan, bleed purple and gold. They met at the 2005 Peach Bowl when LSU beat Miami. Ryan proposed in Tiger Stadium on the Eye of the Tiger.
He walked me out to the 50-yard line and asked me to marry him. And then we took it one more step and we had an LSU-themed wedding with Mike the Tiger at our wedding. When we entered into our reception, they played the fight song and we entered with him. We actually had a tailgate set up in our reception with a exact replica Tiger Stadium groom's cake. So it is no shock to our friends and family that our firstborn would be born on Mike the Tiger's birthday.
Claire's been drooling purple and gold from the moment she was born. She went to her first LSU game at just 3 months old. Loves tailgating and already has a special magic with Mike. Look!
So far every Friday we've been here to come see Mike.
The atmosphere is teeming with animal attraction.
Baby, I'm playing on you tonight. Hunt you down, eat you alive. Just like animals, animals, like animals, moles. Maybe you think that you can hide. I can smell yourself for miles. Just like animals, animals, like animals, moles. Baby, I'm... So what you try to do to me? It's like we can't stop.
He's wonderful. Big, cute little guy. Lots of growing to go.
Speaking of big, cute little guys.
Yeah, got two Tiger fans on my hands.
You come out for you or them?
Well, both, I guess, you know. Everybody enjoys a good time.
Every day, all day.
Come pick up the girls up from gymnastics over at LSU and Port of Opportunities. Come over here and see the new Mike.
What do you think of the new one?
Oh, he's awesome. He's young. He's playful. He's, yeah. Look at him. What is he doing?
I don't know. He sees something he wants. I don't know if it's a bird or your children. I know. Can you believe you live in a place where you can pick your kids up from gymnastics and come see a tiger on the way home?
It's awesome. It's like having a zoo here every day.
Except for those tearful days and months after Mike VI died of cancer. For 314 days, this home was without a tiger.
525,600 minutes.
Construction workers filled some of that space in a $950,000 renovation.
We would just pass by and look at the construction and hope for a new one.
Many feared, amidst animal rights opposition, there might not be a new Mike the Tiger.
It wasn't like we went and got him in the jungle.
Just the opposite. LSU saved his life. Mike's attending veterinarian Dr. David Baker, along with LSU, wouldn't have had it any other way.
It was very important to us that we not take a tiger directly from a breeder. There's a lot of irresponsible breeding of tigers in the U.S. There's more captive tigers than really people can find homes for. And there's a whole dark industry that involves the use of these tigers for various things, dead or alive. And there's a lot of money to be made at every step along the way in that industry. And that was most likely where he was headed, not with the owners that we have, from which we obtained him, but they get caught up in that industry, and he could have gone that way. And so it was important to us to rescue a tiger from that and give him a home that, give a tiger a home that really needed one, and that's what we've done.
The number of tigers worldwide has plummeted 93% in just the last 100 years. We've gone from 100,000 tigers to less than 4,000 now, due to poaching, habitat loss, climate change, and the black market. They're endangered now, but could be extinct in the wild in less than 20 years. That's why LSU has started the U.S. Tiger University Educational Consortium.
That's designed to help save tigers around the world. And that's what we should do as a university. And we've joined Auburn, Missouri, and Clemson in this Global Tiger Alliance that we hope to make sure that these tigers are around for a long, long time. And we've got to do something about this before they might not have a Mike the Eighth.
And Mike's a long-standing LSU tradition. The LSU mascot evolved from just statues of a tiger to a live tiger mascot in 1936. That was so long ago, Bernie Moore was the football coach. Tiger Stadium only held a fourth of the people that it does today at 24,000, and the LSU band only allowed male students. Tiger fan Billy Phillips says continuing Mike's tradition is essential.
All I know is I'm glad we got a tiger. LSU, you know, I always said LSU was not LSU without the band. LSU was not LSU without our tiger.
Mike's line the corridor here. All of the live tiger mascots have been Mike, but why are they Mike? Why weren't they Billy the Tiger or Ted the Tiger? Well, it goes back to 1936, when every LSU student put up 25 cents to raise the $750 to buy the tiger from the Arkansas Zoo. But it was LSU athletic trainer Mike Chambers who was very instrumental in getting a live tiger on campus. So, in honor of Mike Chambers, they named him Mike the Tiger. Mike VII wasn't purchased. He was donated by Wild at Heart Wildlife Center in Okeechobee, Florida. Dr. Baker looked at a lot of tigers across the U.S., but when he saw Harvey, he knew.
It took about 4 seconds. The way he was interacting with us, his conformation, his attitude, the way he looked, I don't know, it's sort of like you know it when you see it.
It's kind of like love?
Sort of, yeah.
You can see Mike loves being here.
He's got it made. Look at him playing in them bushes, you know? His bushes, he can tear them up if he wants to.
That's right.
You know, he loves it. I mean, look at him playing, you know? He loves it here.
He's growing fat and happy. Mike is one big eater. He eats 15 pounds of food a day. He's gaining weight at about a pound a day.
He crossed 200 pounds about a week and a half ago. So right now he's probably about 210 pounds.
Are you pleased with that?
Oh yeah, look at him. He's he's perfect. He's perfectly proportioned. He's doing really well.
Well adjusted too. Even flying didn't faze him.
The transport itself really couldn't have gone much better. From the time we arrived at the facility in Florida, till we were driving back to the airport was less than 20 minutes. Our friends at the Okeechobee County Airport had lined up a forklift and operator to move the crate in and out of the aircraft. Our friends at the Baton Rouge Jet Center had done the same. So we had a lot of help from really professional people, and it made all the difference. It really minimized the transport stress for the tiger.
However, fans might unknowingly be adding stress on Mike by bringing their dogs, even stuffed animals, around his habitat.
Right, I think people just don't understand that he is a predator, but also he's a young, very playful animal. And so when they bring their pets up to the enclosure, he wants to check those out and maybe play with them. And so, but the danger is that he'll throw himself against the glass and possibly break a tooth. And dental problems are the number one cause of death in both wild and captive tigers. And so we take that very, very seriously. So it's very important that people stay away from the enclosure with their pets. And because he's so young and inexperienced, he can't easily tell the difference between a stuffed tiger and a live tiger kitten just yet.
Mike's intrigued and interactive with all his visitors.
And then students, they love him. You see all the students come, they love him. They pumped up. He's gonna love this place. I mean, who wouldn't? Right. Hey, I wouldn't mind living here, you know? Bring my food to me, take care of me, you know?
Free medical care.
That's right, don't have to worry about nothing. No politics or nothing, I'm right there.
And the doctors and the dentists come to you.
That's right.
And only Mike has a temperature-controlled rock.
It's warm in the winter and cool in the summer, so he can lay on it and be comfortable.
You can see him on it game days. Mike 7 won't be on the football field.
Well, this way everybody gets to see him on game day, and it's also less stressful for the tiger. And as a sanctuary site, which we now are, sanctuary animals just aren't taken into venues like that. So it's a new tradition for people to be able to see him on game day, and we think it's one that is better for him, and we always do what is best for Mike.
And those are doctor's orders.
Baker's great. Dr. Baker, this is Dr. Baker's baby, and Mike the sixth was, Mike the fifth was. Dr. Baker takes this very seriously, and our vet students compete every year, and the top vet students get to take care of Mike for the year, which is really a great honor for our vet students.
Has anything about him surprised you?
I think the thing that has surprised me is how quickly he has come to know my students and I. You know, they deal with him twice a day, every day, so that's a little more understandable. But he figured me out within just a few days. I was really surprised at that. I knew they were intelligent animals, but he came to know me very quickly, much more quickly than I would have thought. And he follows me. You can see him. He's right here by me. And he follows me everywhere I go. The thing that I have enjoyed the most about him is how interactive he is. He's very, very vocal, much more so than Mike 6, and very, very interactive with us. People are just crazy about this animal. It's been really good to see and interesting to see, but Mike the Tiger means a lot to the LSU community.
You can find Mike out here every day from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. along with a lot of his fans.